Hello everybody, Ananth here. I do hope that the last video kindled your imagination, that you ransacked it to exactly understand what the previous stages of design thinking meant. That means empathizing, defining, ideating. Now we move over to prototyping, which is nothing but creating a rough model on which you could test whatever are your workable ideas and check how many of them are implementable. So you're basically preparing, this is a preparation stage for the final testing. Now, in the case of this particular case of a hospice center, it has to be, remember one thing, that design thinking is product design, service design, as well as business design. The strategy should be such that it has to be a cost-effective process. So the model that you create, the prototype that you create, has to be cost-effective and not expensive enough. In the case of a simple device like a rocking chair or maybe a stent, it is just a device, so creating a prototype would not be as expensive as in this case of a hospice center, wherein you have to create an actual premises where the test users, sample test users, or member from your own team will have to be put and the ideas may have to be worked upon them. So let's recall what were the workable ideas at the end of the ideation stage that we collected. So we said that we need a particular premises with three stories and private wards for each patient with soft water bodies flowing, cascading around, yeah? And also there were going to be flower beds with hot zinnias, petunias, gerberias, etc. to pep up the patients, or maybe you could call them the inmates. Also, the exterior had to be white. And these were a few workable ideas apart from many others that possibly could come into your mind. You could jot them down too. So you need to create a model or prepare an establishment. Now this looks very theoretical. In this case, we are going to actually test the idea, so we need space for that. Now how do you make it inexpensive? It's actually going in for a premises, not like creating a rocking chair or maybe a hairdryer or even a laptop, where a model of a laptop, which could be comparatively less expensive. So how can we do? We need to keep it as inexpensive as possible. So to create a space like this, we could possibly rent out a space closest in resemblance to whatever is the ideas that you have in hand. So maybe you could rent out a three-storied building complex, which has got similar kind of flower beds and some water body flowing nearby, closest in resemblance, so that you could sit and work upon the same kind of premises. So we need to scale down the whole thing in terms of space, in terms of number of end users, and also in terms of time. We cannot go on and on with this, so we create a certain time period. A prototype is workable for about 1 month, on which we keep, say, 10 to 15 end users. And the building is three-storied with about 10 to 11 rooms or wards on which the end users could be kept upon that. So this is the way the prototyping is done. Now, we have made it ready for the next stage, that is testing. Is this the end of it? Definitely not. Much more will come in the testing period. During when you test the ideas, you come to know that all these workable ideas of this hospice center may not really implementable. So directly from prototyping, we can't jump into coming out with the final product of the hospice center. Remember, the cost involved is very, very high. Additionally, it has to be an experience which benefits the end users. So, I am waiting to share more ideas on how the testing process could throw a new surprises, a few surprises. I would also like you to work upon this and see, now that we have done till the prototyping, try a simple exercise of trying to work it on how a rocking chair could possibly design till this particular stage. I would love to meet you again in the next video to share much more with you. Till then, it is goodbye and have a blast of a day.